Binance is the largest cryptocurrency exchange in the world, and it is that one platform that is very secured, very reliable, very transparent, and they have a lot of very exciting products and features. And it is also available to a lot of countries around the world, including Nigeria. And right now, Binance is one of the best places to invest, buy, or sell cryptocurrencies. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to create and verify your Binance account so that you can get access to the platform without any restriction. The process is actually very simple and will take just a couple of minutes. But before we get started, I want you to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. And also, if you're just coming to the channel for the first time, you're welcome. My name is Emmanuel, and on this channel, I make videos that will help you make money online. And if you want to see more of these kind of videos, make sure you smash the subscribe button, turn on all notifications so that you'll be the first to know whenever I upload a new video. And with all that said, guys, now let me walk you through how to create and verify your Binance account. Alright, so the first thing we want to do is to install the Binance app on our phone. You can do this from the Apple App Store or Google Play Store. So just come over, search for Binance, click on the first result, and then just go ahead and install the app. After installing, let's go ahead and open the app. And right here, you have a lot of options you can sign up with. You can sign up with your email or phone number. You can sign up with your Google account or with your Apple account. If you select sign up with email or phone number, then you can go ahead and enter your email address or your phone number. You can also enter a referral ID. You can use my referral ID. I'll leave it in the description box, although referral ID is optional. And then just go ahead and click on next. But I want to sign up with a Google account. So I'll click continue with Google, continue. I'll go ahead and select the Google account I want to use. And then I'll paste in my referral ID right here and then click on confirm. And with that, your account has been successfully created. If you want to receive marketing updates, you can toggle this button here and then click on done. Next, we will need to log into our newly created account. So I'm going to click on login. And then if you registered using your email address or your phone number, you can enter your email or phone number right here. But I registered with my Google account, so I'm going to continue with Google, select the Google account. So you can see we are done with the first step, which is to create our account. The next step is to verify the account. You need to verify your account before you can get access to start trading cryptocurrencies on the platform. To verify your account, just go ahead and click on verify now. So to start the verification process, you first need to select your country of residence. Mine is already on Nigeria. Then the next step is to provide personal information, submit a government issued ID, and then you'll do a liveness check, and that'll be all. So let's go ahead to all of these steps. I'll click on continue. Nationality, I'm going to select Nigeria. Then legal name, you want to enter your name right here. Let me just enter my name. You want to make sure that the name you enter here corresponds with the name you have on your ID. Then you can go ahead and enter your date of birth and then just click continue. Here you need to enter your residential address and then click continue. Then enter your postal code, the city, and then country, and then click on continue. The next step is document verification. You want to select the issuing country, then select the type of document you want to use. There are a lot of options here. You can use your NIN, your ID card, your passport, or your driver's license. Let's say I'm going to use NIN and then click continue. And for that option, I'm going to enter my NIN, then click I have read and accept Binance privacy policy. After that, just click continue. The next step is face authentication. And for this, you want to avoid wearing hats or wearing glasses or using filters. And then you want to make sure there is enough lighting on your face. To get started, just click on start verification. Here it says Binance would like to access the camera. Click OK. This process is very simple. You just need to follow the instructions. And as simple as that, I'm done with that step. And you can see verification successful. Now I can just go ahead and close. If you follow all these steps correctly, Binance is going to take some time to review and verify your account. Then you have access to all the features on the platform so that you can start buying or selling cryptocurrencies whenever you want to. Now, if I come over to my account section, just click on this account icon. For me, it is showing verification field, and that's because I already have a verified Binance account and I cannot create another account again. And that's one thing you need to know about Binance. You cannot have multiple accounts. But for your new account, if you submit the right information, your account is going to be approved in a very short time so that you can start using the platform. After your Binance account has been verified, you can just come over to security. To make sure your account is secured, you want to use two-factor authentication. So right now, it's just your email that is linked to your account. You can enable passkeys and biometrics. You can also use an authenticator app or your phone number. So that'll just add an extra layer of security to your account. Another thing you can do is to come over to payment methods, where you can add the different payment methods you are going to be using when buying or selling cryptocurrencies on Binance. If you're in Nigeria, the method of buying cryptocurrency on Binance is through P2P, because you cannot use your bank or your bank card. So you can come over to P2P payment methods and then add the payment methods you want to use on your account. Let me log into my verified Binance account and just show you guys how this part works. This is my verified account, and if I come over to payment methods, click on P2P payment method, you are going to see that I've added a number of payment methods already. If you want to add a new payment method to your Binance account, just click on add a payment method. And then you want to select the option you want to use. The basic thing you want to do is to add your bank account as a payment method, so that when you are selling your cryptocurrencies on P2P, that's where your payment will be sent to. So you can just select bank transfer. Then go ahead and enter your bank account number and your bank name. Then you can click on confirm. But aside from bank account, you can add a lot of other payment methods to your Binance account. If I scroll down, you are going to see all payment methods at the down. Click on it, and then you can get select the payment method you want to use. Let's say if you want to add your Skrill account, for instance, you can just come over here, search for Skrill, select it, then enter your Skrill email, and then just click on confirm. And once you have all of these in place, you are actually ready to start using Binance for your cryptocurrency needs. And that's basically it for this video, guys. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.